for Melody Rance and Gene Autry.
I'm back in the saddle again, out where a friend is a friend, where the longhorn cattle feed on the lowly Jimson weed. I'm back in the saddle again.
That's right, folks. It's another visit with all the gang here at Melody Ranch. There's Pat Buttram, the Cass Colley Boys, the Gene Autry Blue Jeans, Carl Kottner's Melody Ranch Hardway 6, and yours truly, Charlie Lyon. Right now, though, meet the boss man himself, America's favorite cowboy, Gene Autry.
Brothers and sisters, here's the lowdown. When it comes time to have a showdown, there's nothing like a good old-fashioned hoedown to chase your blues away. When Lady Luck gives you the throwdown, when old man worry starts to mow down, there's nothing like a good old-fashioned hoedown to brighten up your day. Grab your partner, swing her around, and circle on your heel. 1, 2, 3, 4, grease your knee for a real Virginia reel. Get ready now and put your toe down, and once you've started, don't you slow down. There's nothing like a good old-fashioned hoedown to chase your blues away. Grab your partner, swing her around, and circle on your heel. 1, 2, 3, 4, grease your knee for a real Virginia reel. Get ready now and put your toe down, and once you've started, don't you slow down. There's nothing like a good old-fashioned hoedown to chase your blues away. Well, hello, everybody, and welcome again to Melody Ranch. Things are kind of quiet out here on the spread tonight because I am tired and I'm weary, but I must toil on till the Lord comes to call me away, where the morning is bright and the lamb is the light, and the night is as fair as the day. There will be peace in the valley for me someday. There will be peace in the valley for me, I pray.
No more sorrow and sadness, our troubles will be.
There will be peace in the valley for me. There the bear will be gentle, the wolf will be tame, and the lion will lay down by the lamb. The host from the wild will be led by a child, and I'll be changed from the creature that I am. There will be peace in the valley for me someday. There will be peace in the valley for me, I pray.
No more sorrow and sadness, our troubles will be.
There will be peace in the valley for me.
Well, thank you. Thank you a lot. I'm glad you liked it.
Hi, Mr. Audrey.
Hello there, Patrick.
Yeah, I'm sure glad I got here in time to hear that song.
Well, I am too, yeah. Pat. Say, you look like something left over from a Halloween party.
Yeah. Now, wait, now. Don't be funny. This is my football suit.
Oh, a football suit.
Yeah, I'm playing today with the Sagebrush Polecats.
Oh. Well, you're wearing the nose guard, I can see.
Yeah, it keeps me from breathing. The Polecats is a very strong team.
Say, what position do you play on this football team?
Oh, everything. Mostly in the backfield.
Backfield?
Yeah. Every time I carry the ball, I'm good for 20 yards.
20 yards every time?
Yes, sir. I run in the wrong direction. There's less opposition that way.
I see. Pat, have you ever actually played in a game?
I sure have.
Oh, you have?
Last Saturday, I played quarterback.
Is that so?
You ought to see me work the old hidden ball play. Oh, was it a mess? Ooh.
How come?
I forgot where I hid the ball. You know, the other team outweighed us by 500 pounds.
500 pounds?
Yes, sir.
You must have been playing Oklahoma.
Oh, no, no. But in the closing minutes, I grabbed the ball and I took off like a wounded moose. Oh, did I run? Crazy legs, Buttram. That was me. I got in a clear. I was heading for the goal line when out of nowhere's come their left tackle. Dived at my legs. But I kept a running.
Yeah, boy, I bet you did, boy.
You should have heard the crowd roar.
Oh, the crowd roared, huh?
Yeah.
Did you make a touchdown?
No, I looked back and the tackle had my pants.
I see.
So long, Mr. Artery.
Well, so long, Patrick. Oh, brother, that Buttram. Well, I don't know if he's any better as a halfback on the team or a nickelback on the bottle. Well, let's sit back here and hear the Cass County boys make a score. I know that they're ready, willing, and able.
I'm ready, willing, and able. And honey, now it's up to you. So lay your cards on the table and tell me what you plan to do. I'm ready, able, and willing to join you in a little fun. But I won't take second billing. I gotta be your number one. I'm ready to give you my heart, dear. I'm willing to hand you the key. I'm able to say from the start, dear, it's never belonged to anyone else but me. I'm ready, willing, and able. So if you want a love that's true, then lay your cards on the table. 'Cause honey, now it's up to you. Heart full of loving, with no one around you to share. An arm full of good lovey-doving. So honey, come on, I got a lot to spare. I'm ready, willing, and able. So if you want a love that's true, then lay those kings and aces on the table, Mabel. 'Cause honey, now it's up to you.
Well, Cass County boys, that song ought to be mighty popular with the jukebox crowd. Your picture on the table, a smile upon your face, and still I can't help feeling all alone. The letters that you write me can never take your place. It just don't seem like home when you're gone. Don't that ring on your finger mean anything to you? Just let it little quarrels wreck our home. I beg you to forgive me like I've forgiven you. It just don't seem like home when you're gone. Some friends drop by to see us just like they used to do, but my heart couldn't tell them why you're gone. Don't know how we've missed you, because they love you too. It just don't seem like home when you're gone.
That sign upon the matter will live forevermore. Remember what it says, God bless our home. The welcome mat is waiting to greet you at the door. It just don't seem like home when you're gone.
That's a funny one, Gene.
Well, thank you, folks. Thank you very, very much.
You know, Mr. Artery, you know, along about this time of year, I get a real strong hankering to head south.
Well, I don't know how any place could be any nicer than Melody Ranch at this time of the year, Patrick. As far as I'm concerned, the scenery is great, the air is wonderful, and it's home.
Yeah, but when the first winter wind comes, I start wanting the hot weather that I've been fighting all summer long.
I see.
Right now, I wouldn't mind being down around the border. Hey, you worked down there for quite a spell, didn't you?
Yeah, sure did, Pat. But that was quite a while back. You know, I was foreman on Ed Noble's ranch down there. It was an exciting place, too. I remember one day, just about dinner time, when I was sitting on the porch of the ranch house, looking out over the wide open spaces. A young fella in faded blue jeans came riding around the bunkhouse on his roan mare. Stopped his horse, shoved his hat back on his head, dismounted, and walked up to the porch steps toward me.
Adam, I'm looking for Gene Autry, the foreman of this layout.
I'm Gene Autry. What can I do for you?
Well, my name's Tom Black. I got an idea you may want to give me a job.
Well, we can always use another rider. Where have you been riding before?
Oh, maybe this here badge will tell you better than I can.
Oh. Border Patrol.
Yeah. Reckon that'll get me a job?
That's a ticket for just about any kind of a job you want on this ranch. You're just in time for dinner, Tom. Cody?
Yeah, I'll be right there, Gene.
I'll have Cody show you to your quarters. You can meet the rest of the gang later.
Okay, just one thing.
Anything you say.
I'd appreciate it if you don't tell the rest of the boys about my real job.
If that's the way you want it, Tom. Anything else you want to tell me?
Well, the chances are I'll have to call on you for help later. Somebody's moving cattle from over the border into this country, and it's my job to stop them.
I see.
You want me, Gene?
Oh, yeah, Cody. This is a new rider, Tom Black. Cody's been with us quite a while, Tom. He can show you around here.
Well, sure. I'd be glad to. Hope you like it here, Tom.
Expect to, thank you. Well, thanks to you, too, Gene. I think this is going to work out fine.
Well, things appeared to be doing fine. Tom seemed to know how to handle every job that I gave him, and he did a good job of covering up his real reason for being there. But his self-assurance seemed to be somewhat shaken one afternoon when the postman brought him a letter. I began to understand why. Shortly after that, when we came over, and he said to me,
"Say, Gene, is it all right with you if I ride fences down along the river for the next few days?"
"Sure, whatever you say, Tom. Something up?"
"Yeah, this letter. Seems somebody's building up a herd of cattle just across the river, and I'm supposed to look into it."
"Well, good luck. If I can help you in any way, let me know."
"Oh, thanks, Gene. I sure will. Well, wait a minute."
"What's the matter?"
"Cody, come in."
"Well, I was just fixing to come in."
"Gene, how long has this fella been around here?"
"Why, is there anything wrong?"
"Oh, I'm sure he was listening to us outside that door."
"You sure are a suspicious cut."
"And this is not the first time I've caught him snooping. Why, are you out of..."
"Now, wait a minute. Cut that out, both of you. We got a good ranch crew, and I'm not going to have any fights around here. Now, if there's any unfriendliness, I want you to get it settled and settle it fast. If you can't settle it, I can."
"Well, maybe I better be riding on, Gene."
"Well, I hate to say it, Cody, but maybe you're right. You better collect your check in the morning. I'm sorry that it worked out this way."
"Ah, it's all right, Gene. If I stayed around here, Black and I'd just have more trouble. I'll go pack."
"You did the right thing in getting rid of him, Gene. I've been suspicious of him from the first day I set foot on this ranch. You ain't gonna miss him any."
So Cody Williams moved out the next morning. Tom Black went off to ride the fences along the border. He came up to the ranch house about once a week to check with me, but outside of that, I didn't see very much of him. And then one day, Johnny Martin stopped by to see me on the ranch.
Hey, Gene.
Yeah, Johnny?
I got a message for you.
Oh, is that so?
Yeah, that new feller you hired, you know, Tom Black.
Yeah.
Well, he said for you to get all us boys together down at the river tonight. Says there's going to be some action that you'd know what that meant.
Oh, I see. Yeah, I think I know what he means, Johnny.
Well, what'll I tell him?
Well, you tell Tom that he can count on us. We'll be there and ready for any excitement that he can stir up. While the boys were having their supper, I told them just part of the plans for the evening. Asked them to be in bed as usual, but to get out and get saddled up about midnight and be ready to ride. In the meantime, I went back to the ranch house to wait for a telephone call. Hello? Yeah. Yeah, I've been sitting here waiting for your call. What'd you find out? Yeah, I understand. But how far below the river bend is it? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think I've got him. Okay, see you later. Because it's so important, Johnny, tell me again, where did Black say for us to meet him?
At the willow thicket, just north of the bend is where he told me.
Okay, boys, the rest of you go with Johnny and wait for Black at the willow grove till I get there. Yeah. I waited for Johnny and the boys to get away. Then I got on Champ and headed off in a slightly different direction. I couldn't help but think that some trick was in the making, so I decided to see for myself.
Oh, them coyotes is really howling up a storm tonight, ain't they?
Yeah, sure. Gee, how long are we supposed to wait for Black?
Well, he said he'd be here at midnight.
It's almost 1 o'clock now.
Don't make no difference. We gotta wait for Gene anyhow.
Here comes somebody now. Maybe it's Black.
Whoever it is, he's training for a race or racing for a train. I don't know which. Well, where you been, Gene?
Oh, I've been on a little scouting trip, Johnny.
Well, Black didn't show up yet, and it's after 1 o'clock.
Well, we're not waiting for anybody. Across the river and about a mile below, there's a herd of about 200 head of cattle ready to be driven across. Let's get going. Well, looks like we're here in plenty of time, boys. And I think those smugglers are in for quite a surprise.
I'll say one thing. Behind this ridge is a great spot to hide in.
Johnny.
Yeah?
You crawl up on top of that rise and keep a lookout.
Okay.
When you see the last of the herd coming ashore, give us a signal.
Why wait so long, Gene?
Well, we want to get all those smugglers and stampede the cattle back on the other side.
Okay.
Now, look. It's going to be up to each one of you to grab one of the men. And remember, we want them alive.
We're about halfway across, Gene.
Well, let them get in closer. Okay, be ready, boys. We'll take them before they have a chance to get organized. All right, head off the cattle. Get the smugglers. All right, everybody, pick your man. I'll take the leader. Come on, Champ. Let's go, boy. Hey, you. Pull up there. You might get shot.
Get that, young man, Audrey. I'm going for help.
Wrong kind of help, Black. Come on, Champ. Let's go, boy. This will take care of you, Mr. Black.
Gene, are you all right?
Sure, I'm fine. And here's your chief smuggler, all ready for you.
Oh, thanks, Gene. Thanks for all your help.
Hey, we got every one of them smugglers, Gene. And I can see you got the leader, Cody Williams,
huh? Yeah, you better guess again, Johnny. Tom Black's the leader.
Tom Black? But he gave me the idea he was connected some way with the Border Patrol.
Yeah, and he tried to give me the same idea, Johnny. but we already had a border patrol man around here. Cody Williams.
Well, well, Cody and Black got into an argument. You sent Cody packing.
Cody and I laid a trap for Black. Black's gang has been responsible for bringing a lot of cattle into this country.
Yeah, there's been a lot of hoof and mouth disease along the border, Johnny. The border patrol's been trying to trace the source. Now we've found it.
Well, Black's sure out cold, ain't he? You should get a promotion for catching him, Cody.
Well, Gene's the one that caught him, Johnny. So far as a promotion is concerned, I'm leaving the border patrol. This was my last assignment. Tomorrow, I'm heading towards home, right up the Navajo Trail.
Well, we were sure glad to help Cody Williams on his last assignment. We wished him good luck and a well-deserved rest. For Cody was typical of the men of the Border Patrol. Quiet, hard-working, efficient, and loyal. And as a salute to them, here is our cowboy classic for today, Along the Navajo Trail. Every day, along about evening, when the sunlight's beginning to fade, I ride to the slumbering shadows along the Navajo Trail. When it's night and crickets are calling and the coyotes are making a wail, I dream by a smoldering fire along the Navajo Trail. I love to lie and listen to the music when the wind is strumming a sagebrush guitar. When over yonder hill the moon is climbing, it always finds me wishing on a star. Well, what do you know? It's morning already. There's the dawning, so silver and pale. It's time to climb into my saddle and ride the Navajo Trail. Navajo Trail.
Golly, Gene, you sure picked a favorite song of mine that time. Maybe you got the idea from hearing me whistle it every now and then, hmm?
Well, that just could be, Charlie. And I know if you like that song, a lot of our friends will like it, too. Well, folks, it's time to say so long to our guests and invite everyone to be with us again for another Melody Ranch powwow over these same radio stations. Until then, this is Gene Autry asking you to keep thinking of us.
Next week at this same time, Gene Autry and all the gang from Melody Ranch will be heard over these same stations. This is Charlie Lyon inviting you to be tuned our way.
This is the United States Armed Forces Radio and Television Service.